Hello everybody, welcome to this week's assembly. For our prayer, we're going to listen to Be Thou My Vision, which is one of my favourite hymns. And yes, I am the sort of person who has favourite hymns. This is probably a different version than you're used to. It's by a band called Wren Collective, so let's have a listen. Last week in our assembly, we introduced a new segment, Rathmore Daily News, with Chuck McLarry and Eugene Weatherson. Let's see what they have to tell us this week. And welcome to the Rathmore Daily News, what one person in YouTube described as the only news source we can trust. I'm Chuck McLarry, and these are your top stories. We begin with the news that Year 9 pupils have been researching Campylobacter as part of their food safety course in home economics. The World Health Organization describes Campylobacter as the main cause of gastroenteritis around the world. The pupils have been designing posters, like this one by Anna Phoenix. Now to the news that Year 10 pupils have started a project in design and technology. They will be making homemade planters out of recyclable material. They are currently in the design stage. We hope to bring you more on this story next week. Now some breaking news just in. Let's go live to our reporter.
Yes, Chuck, we've had an anonymous tip-off. Apparently there has been some movement in the toiletries aisle. We are headed down there now, and as soon as we get any more information, we'll let you know. Back to you in the studio.
We'll keep you up to date with that developing story. It's been a difficult time, both locally and globally, for businesses. Our Year 11 Business Studies pupils have been looking at the challenges they face. As part of this, they took part in a competition to design some socially distanced advertisements for brands. The winner was Ellie McDonald, who produced this poster for Gap. In other news, the artist of the week for this week has again been announced. Well done to Felicity Mooney, who produced this brilliant piece of work. And now we can go live back to our reporter, who has an update on those toilet rolls.
Thanks, Chuck. Yes, we're live here in the supermarket, and we're just going to have a wee look to see what the toilet roll situation is. And as you can see, yes, they're all very well stocked. Nothing to panic about. Back to you in the studio.
Thank goodness for that. We'll all sleep a little easier tonight. Now it's time for the weather. Let's go straight to Eugene Weatherson.
Thanks, Chuck. Yes, confirmation right now that it is still pretty sunny, but we're expecting some sort of showers any minute now. And then what may happen later is we're thinking the temperature may drop, and at that point we may experience just a little bit of snowfall. Back to you in the studio.
Like, is he even a real weatherman? And he has sent me about 50 invitations to his silly little Zoom quizzes.
Chuck! Yes, Chuck, I'm still here.
But I was just...
I can hear everything you've said. No, Chuck, I sent you one invitation to one Zoom quiz, and that was it. I'll tell you what, Chuck, never again. I am done with you, and I am done with this news channel. I am gone.
Yep. Okay. This has been Rathmore Daily News. See you soon. Well, that was fairly awkward. I've been asked by Eugene, well, in a me talking to the voices in my head sort of way, if you would follow him on Twitter. His Twitter handle is @weather_Eugene. Now, every week we give you different things that you can try during lockdown. This week is no different. We've got our activities edition of stuff to do. Hello everybody and welcome to this week's episode of Stuff to Do. It's our activities edition. I'm going to show you a few random things you can try during the lockdown. Let's check it out.
Okay, so you can turn your car into a playground, can climb.
It's vitally important that we regularly wash our hands during this period, and in order to remind myself of that, I've been setting myself different challenges. Here is the hand washing challenge.
Wash, washy, wash, washy, wash, wash your hands.
Okay guys, we're back for another hand washing challenge. This week, just under 30 seconds to see how many Jaffa Cakes I can eat. Now the world record for a minute is 17 Jaffa Cakes. So if we scale that down, world record about 8 for 30 seconds. If I do anything more than 3, to be honest, I'll be happy. Let's go for it. About 3.5, good enough effort.
Total eclipse.
Full disclosure, originally I was going to eat cream crackers, but I couldn't even eat half a cream cracker, so I had to change it to Jaffa Cakes. That's all I have time for this week, and I will see you all next week. Chuck McLarry, seriously, who does he think he is? I tell you one thing, he'll not be getting the friendship bracelet I was making for him, no siree. And I am finished with Rathmore Daily News. I seriously cannot believe some people.
Gaudete, gaudete, Christus est natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete.